There's
a lady there in a wheelchair that would like to speak.
Oh! Can we let this lady pass? Sure. Come. Can you make it get here?
Thank you.
We'll make sure. Thank you, Mary. I'm going to give this microphone to you.
Okay, darling.
Need to be closer.
A bit closer. No, she doesn't. That's a really good microphone. It's a really close microphone, so it picks up mostly the person and not others.
Right, so let me bring it up. Shall I go?
Yes.
Yeah? Hi, my name's Natalie. Been trying to get to this event for some time, and as I'm disabled, I feel a little vulnerable. So I was weary of coming alone, and I've been unable to find anyone local to meet with me. But this week, with the help of all the lovely ladies of this movement on Twitter, very kind lady offered to meet me at Liverpool Street. So I'd like to say a huge thank you to her for coming with me. I can't tell you how grateful I am. I used to have my own little gardening business. I was a groundsman for a local primary school. I was also a lorry driver. But life changes. I'm now a disabled single parent of two children. My son has a brain injury with epilepsy, and my daughter is at sixth form. She's also a young carer to both of us, bless her. She helps with some of my personal care, and on my bad days, she also helps me around the house. There's 10 years between my kids. I first peaked after hearing about the things my daughter was learning about in school. That first grabbed my attention. In class, she was told there are 100 genders in PHSC lessons. I laughed as I thought it was a joke. Then she said many of her classmates were now trans and she didn't know how to cope with that or how to be around them without losing friends. She felt many were just mixed up and not trans at all. She thought they just wanted to be part of the trend. I kept a close eye on what she was learning after that and what was happening around her. I explained that I believe sex is binary, cannot be changed no matter what and why I believe that. You can't ignore the reality of science and feelings don't change science. I saw on TV a parade in the Pride Month where men dressed as dogs were pulled along the floor by leaves with kids around them. Men who had all their parts were saying, sorry, I've lost my place. Pride Month, where men dressed as dogs were pulled along on the floor by leads with kids around them. Men who had all their parts saying they were women, going into our safe spaces, our girls in our changing rooms, our female prisons, and in our care facilities. I fear for our children going to these areas alone when who knows who also now allowed in there. They've been handed more validation to access them, which will encourage trouble. Many of these things were fetishes, and I'd seen in big nightclubs years ago, but I never ever thought they'd work their way into our children's safe spaces and schools. Then I heard about children being sent down the rabbit hole with so-called transitioning as adolescents, mutilating surgeries and being fed lies about changing sex, and you'll be happy. It was almost disbelief of what I was hearing. Then I saw Kellie-Jay, and it was like a breath of fresh air. So I knew I had to follow her, and that was when I peaked and realised what was going on and how far this lunacy was reaching in our single spaces, our services and our sports. My daughter now has to worry in school about boys being in her female spaces. They changed some of the toilets in school to gender neutral, mixed sex, so that the trans kids feel included. Many of the girls hate it, as do the boys. She now feels exposed and vulnerable and feels sick with worry that she'll have no choice but to use these loos, and they're in the sixth form block and you can't use other areas' facilities because of school restrictions. She suffers with severe menorrhagia and dysmenorrhea, which means she has exceptionally heavy periods and pain. Sometimes, no matter how much she prepares, she'll leak and we'll need to change her clothing and rinse clothes of her trousers or skirt in the toilets. She now has to worry about boys and trans kids coming into these spaces when this happens. She vomits with the pain. And again, instead of having a safe space to go to, she now has boys laughing. If the pain's really bad, it was also her sanctuary while waiting for painkillers to kick in. The library's always used for classes. There's no first aid rooms. So this was the only place she felt she could go to. Now she can't. When she goes out now, she has to consider who may be in the toilets, the changing rooms, what men will be in there. Men have been caught taking pictures in our area under the cubicles of the women changing or opening curtains while the girls are changing. That's happened to me as well. I mean, for God's sake, enough. Why the hell don't companies give us stuff about the safety and dignity of our girls and our women in their shops and stores? It's predators' feelings over girls' safety. We see that now over and over. I've now given my daughter a self-defense pepper spray and a key alarm fob. When is enough enough? How many girls have to get hurt before things change? I have health issues with my lungs. I also have issues with causes that terrible pain in my muscles, my eyes, and on some days, extreme exhaustion. I black out, I have chronic pain. I broken my back on 3 occasions, once in a car crash, second times while I was pregnant, 5 months pregnant with my daughter. I also cracked my hips and my pelvis. And a third, due to blackouts, I stepped off the stairs and fell and somersaulted and crushed my spine and fractured my skull. I don't do things by halves. It was after I had my daughter that I had to use the wheelchair. All this means I've spent a lot of time in hospital over the years and needed carers at home. It's bad enough needing to go in, but these days I now dread it with added worry because I know I may not be allowed to have female-only care. When I broke my back in 2012 and was completely immobile, I had to be washed with a bunch of staff all holding my body in place while they turned me one side to the other. I thought I would only have female help, but I was wrong. They used men, and when I complained, I was told either I have the care or I have none at all. Then I have carers at home and they specified that I only wanted female care. And again, they sent men. So on those days, I got no care at all because I sent them away. Am I allowed any dignity? Am I allowed any dignity? Sorry, it keeps jumping. Am I allowed any dignity at all to choose what sort of care I have? Isn't it my right to decide who touches me? For those that say to me I should be grateful of the care, I am grateful, but shouldn't I get to choose? Do I not matter? Do my feelings not matter? To all those that argue I should be grateful, I say this, may it never happen to you. It's easy to preach when you're not a victim of sexual assault and domestic abuse, when it's not you having men or trans women, men washing and touching your most intimate areas. You have no idea of the overwhelming feeling of panic when you're in that situation. It should be my right. I had good reason for not wanting men in my space. In 1991, my son's father had become extremely violent, kicking me, punching me, and raping me. I finally left when he hurt my son, when he was just 18 months old. I tried to press charges, but although he admitted what he'd done in counselling, it wasn't admissible in court, so he walked away. They did give me a restraining order. Several years later, I met my daughter's father, who I loved very, very much. Sorry, it keeps jumping, I can't help it. He'd hurt me. I thought he'd never hurt me. I loved him so much, yet he did. While I was pregnant with my daughter, broke my back, hips and pelvis. So at 5 months pregnant, I left. So for the last 18 years, I've now been alone and I've stayed single because I feel I can't trust my choices in men, some of which I put down to growing up in a very violent home. I came close to ending it all as I thought my children were better off without me. I hadn't made good choices, now they had disabled mother too. I felt I was holding them back, but I spent several years working on myself and went to a group for women for survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault and rebuilt myself. I also wanted to break that cycle for my daughter so that she wouldn't have to suffer abuse. I just hope that it's worked with what I've spoken to her about, and to help her to listen to her internal alarm bells. Never not listen to her internal alarm bells if she's worried at all. Sorry, it keeps jumping. There we are. Yes, I hope I have. I've taught my daughter about boundaries and internal alarm bells and to always listen to them. I've taught my son that he must respect women and why and how he can do that. Women have reasons for not wanting men in their spaces, and having a man say he's a woman doesn't make any damn difference at all. I know there are many, many good, decent men around, and I'm truly grateful for them, but we don't know which ones are predatory and those who aren't. So all of you, stay the fuck out of our spaces, please. Women fought long and hard for our single spaces, services, sports. So to all those men who say they're trans women, get your own. When I go to the loo in a public area, the single disabled toilets are often closed and I have to struggle into the women's. That means I may need to leave the door open to transfer to the chair, to the loo. Now I've got to worry about men being in there. It's embarrassing enough without having to worry about that. Am I not allowed any dignity as a disabled woman, or don't I care? Don't I count? As I age, I know I'll very likely need to go into care as I get older, and the thought of it makes me feel physically sick. We all know disabled women in care are at high risk of being assaulted. I see stories of men who self-ID as women, abusing women in charge of giving their intimate care. It terrifies me. I feel that I have no control over my own life and what will become of me. Men putting on a frock and lipstick or feeling you're a woman, don't make it so. It never will, no matter how much you want it to. And women, you can't be men. Just give... We know many of these men. They're sexual predators, they're AGPs, or just plain creeps. So please get some help and mental health support, but stay away from us. What man in his right mind wants a cervical smear when he has no cervix? Or think it's brave to crush a woman's skull and jaw in MMA? Or to smash all female records after being woeful in a men's category? Where's your pride? To all those bodies that enable this, shame on you all. Kids, you can't change sex. Non-binary doesn't exist. Don't listen to the lies. To Kellie-Jay, I'd really like to say thank you. You really opened my eyes to the huge, to a huge cost I know it is to you. I know this fight is having on you, but thank you for fighting for women and children, my daughter, and thank you for bringing those stories to all those that are yet to be peaked. I'd also like to thank all the women who have spoken before over the events and have given me the strength to finally come and speak myself today. You're all amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I'm just worried I've got makeup on your lovely white coat. Thank you so much for speaking.
That's right. Thank you for doing this.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Can we clear a bit of a space so Natalie can be somewhere? I just want to say on the... So we come here and it's all quite dramatic. And then what we have is we have a woman that talks about that, and you're like, Jesus Christ. And then while she's talking, you've got those fucking assholes behind her trying to wrestle in to do what to us? I have no idea. But this is not the time that we will give up. This is not the time that we will leave this area and give up our space. Because whatever happens, we will let women speak! But, anyway.